A new Prime Minister, a change of direction, but not enough to deviate from a tough immigration policy that's irritated Samoa for years.
We exchange ideas on how to move forward. Certainly, this is a challenge.
Samoa rarely fills its annual 1,100 ballot places, as those accepted in the quota often struggle to find the required permanent job before they get to New Zealand.
We are asking New Zealand to re-examine that.
Both of us agree that there is these competing interests of yes, the value of remittances and yes, the value of having that skills exchange, but also ensuring that there is the retention and return of skills back to Samoa.
Jacinda Ardern's first Pacific trip as leader is about building relationships in a region that spent the last 9 years forging ties with a national government. Politically, if body language is anything to go by, she has some way to go. But at grassroots level, it's a different story.
You would be a member of this village because you have come here in moments of crisis.
For Samoa, that crisis stems from the increasing number of cyclones and their devastating impacts. Teresa Fa'avei lost her home and also a family member during Cyclone Evan in 2012. She's one of 290 families to receive a new house with the help of several aid partners.
Unexpected. Don't know what to say, but as for me, it's my home.
More than 1,000 families here applied for one.
The demand is huge, and I know that you would want other families to benefit too. So my hope is that we can perhaps in the future support you to do that.
New Zealand's announced a $3 million aid package to help Samoa with its recovery from Cyclone Geta, and also to help protect the people here from future storms. Jacinda Ardern has weathered her first test in the Pacific, a region that will continue to count on New Zealand's support in times of need. Barbara Drever, One News, Apia.
And Barbara joins us now live from Apia. So a warm welcome for the Prime Minister today, Barb, but is that likely to last?
Oh, look, she certainly got off on the right foot. The people here have responded really well to her warmth on a personal level, especially in the villages that she visited today. And there's a lot of pride as well, because two of the ministers who are travelling with her are Pacific Islanders. On a political level, well, the jury's out. Like with anything new, there is some uncertainty about policies going ahead. But one thing that is certain is that New Zealand and Samoa have always had a rock-solid relationship, and that's not going to change anytime soon.